you want to know.
Oh, I got this a whoop, huh? Hold on a minute.
This is on one of the traxxas chassis.
And as you see, I modified the chassis here. As you see. For the transmission plate to fit. CX10 transmission. Vanquish Hertz V2D. Actual axles. Still got it. Still use the traxxas drive shells. Four link conversion. No pin hard mount. Servo mount mounted to the axle. See, that's where the winch battery goes to. The remote, I'll show you. This is a radio link RCJ. Radio link RC6GS. Six channel remote transmitter. As you see, battery disconnected. Well, you know it's going to make a rough noise on the servo out there. Possibly I'm screwed it up. But it still works. Four wheel, two wheel. Might push this button. VR is the main. The what do you call it? Where it comes. So I chairs. Reverse the steering. Reverse the throttle. You reverse the channel 3. Also be going the other way. Locking the front axle instead, making a free roll. And the VR was on channel 3. That's what I need to make it lock. LKA. $74.94. Unit $79.99. $37.40. $5.95. on June. Then about to pop this right here. And the servo horn for $2 in June. And to get it three gear with a spur shaft. So with the screws. So I'm gonna mount it. Turn this upside down, I'll show you. Upside down. Nice and two wheel. The only doing it causes the dry shelf catching. And I'll put on the dry shelf. Causes it on the wedge carburetor. What I need to do here is get it fixed. I'll show you how to do it. Go back up here. See, it's burning. See, it's making noise. Lowered it down. But it does better when it's on the wheels. Link on there. It's still too long. Gotta shorten it up. The reason why it's grabbing. The reason why it's still grabbing right there. Because the link on there is still too long. Gotta shorten it up a little bit more. Still does good. See the steering, 75% on both sides, 100% of throttle on either. Even though the reverse is slow as hell. The steering is 15% to straighten it up a little bit. See, that's locked now. But it'll work better when it's all upside on the wheels. And lock sometimes. All depends on the servo. The servo needs to be replaced. So I gotta go back up here to tighten it up a little bit more. Let's see how I did. The last time I had to change out the batteries, screwed up my dang servo. That's the one thing about keeping in memory. Right now I got a Ford Bronco. You're on 64. See what happens. Hey, grab now. This remote, you even got delay to it. I didn't even update the software on it. It's from firmware. I didn't even update it. There it comes. Gear. High, low. Lock. Rear lock. The front and rear. As you see how wide this is compared to the traxxas and MC305. See, one thing is you're gonna have to use two hands to steer it. As you see here, I can't hardly touch this. I'm gonna track this. But this here I can. But I'm gonna use two hands for this. See, I swapped the channel 3 and channel 4 out. It's making a noise. All I gotta do is readjust. That's how it works. Remote, everything I put on there, about $300 or more. And still, the traxxas chassis. Show the name. Whatever the name is. See, traxxas right there. Let me knock this off. See, traxxas chassis modified for an axle. Even though it's still the traxxas model, traxxas CX10 transmission, vanquish, Hertz, big unit, transmission plate, 4-link conversion. Show axles. Put the battery back here. People wonder why I'm putting the battery back here. Because of that. And as I may modify it again, put the battery on top of this. But I would have it back here. Winch battery here. The only thing I need new do is get better socks, since I removed the coils from the socks here and then lift it up some so it won't be all solid flat. And lift it up at that right there so it can look like the old 90 millimeters in the front, 100 in the back. It costs a lot of money, a lot of fixing up. And this here is the winch receiver. See how I got it fixed? Keep the wires from dragging.